My name is Thomas Imboyo from Nikon, Nairobi Comic Convention.
And Thomas, what is Nikon?
Nikon is Nairobi Comic Convention.
Yes.
Yeah. Our version of San Diego Comic Con or New York Comic Con or MCM London. So any other version of a pop culture event,
yeah,
we are doing it in East Africa.
So who attends the event?
Nikon, basically our target audience is people who love movies, people who love animation, people who love gaming, comic books, who love cosplaying, anything around the pop culture is a platform, is an avenue for guys to be able to come and experience.
And how many years has it been running?
We've been running it for 2 years. Our first event was in 2014, and the last one we did was last year, so 2 years running.
And how many people come to the event?
The biggest turnout we had was 3,000 guys coming for the event. But we know there's potential for even more people coming for the event.
And how big is the comic culture in Kenya?
In Kenya, the comic culture, we don't have statistics to prove the figures, but the interest in the content that's produced out of comic books. What I mean by that is basically the movies. If you see Batman vs. Superman coming out, if you see Marvel movies coming out, the queues at movie cinemas are huge. And movies are big business in Kenya. So the interest in comic books, the interest in just people reading stories that throw them outside, beyond reality, is here and is.
You're slightly underselling yourself, so tell me about some local examples of people who make comics.
Local examples, we have someone called Moritz. He does a comic book called The Dawn. We have someone called Point Blank. He does a comic book called... slips my mind. It's an investigative comic book. It's actually black and white.
Yeah.
We have someone called Movin Were. He does Shuri Wanda. It's kind of like a version of... our version of Wonder Woman, if you read it and you have an idea of who Wonder Woman is. We have locally guys who do comic book of legendary comic... mythological stories from our cultures called Wanda Magere. We have someone called Karin. She does, it's called Aletnam. If you read it backwards, it will tell you,
yeah,
tell you what it actually means, but it's majorly geared towards African heroes.
Yeah.
And it celebrates actually real life African heroes in a fictional kind of way.
And lastly, there's a comic app, isn't there? Tell me about that briefly.
There's a comic app. The local guys who developed a comic book application. It's called 254 Comics. That was basically developed to counter the problem we have with publications, and which is a big problem for comic book artists. Locally, we found out the problem was we don't have big budgets. So someone who's making a comic book, he's the writer, he's the inker, he's the penciler,
yeah,
he will market it, he will sell it. So he's doing all this himself or herself, and then at the end of the production has to foot the bill to the publisher to have it mass produced and then sell it himself with no guarantee of returns, which is also the problem the publishers have, because there's no statistic on these are the sales you've had or previous editions have had. And so the application was made because we want to have people have that independence of where you don't have to foot that bill of selling it, reduce the burden from the comic creators. And so the application is that answer. We have a huge penetration of mobile smartphones in Kenya. We pride in being a tech savvy. We are the savannah, we're the Silicon savannah. And so a lot of people, there's a very big population of guys who have smartphones, and that's the target we're looking at. Once someone has completed their comic book, they can be able to just let guys download it at a cost.